Hey, what's up, guys? I'm so sorry that I have not been posting. Like, it's just been a lot that was going on. Like, I had got caught up with 3 papers, and like, it's just been so much. So I'm definitely gonna try my best to keep uploading regularly so you guys can get more content, more videos, so I can keep you guys entertained. All right. Hey, what's up, guys? It's your girl Nene J. I'm back at it again with another video. If this is your first video that you ever seen of me, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you can keep up with my future updates. All right, so today we're gonna be talking about Designated Survivor episodes 12 and 13. 12 was the one that had premiered last Wednesday, and 13 was the one that had came on yesterday. Okay, so with episode 12. Okay, first, it starts off with the recap where Kirkman had got shot and Jason got framed. And then when Agent Wells was in, she was in holding when they were investigating her and everything, because they thought that maybe she was the one that was out to get Kirkman, but that wasn't even the case. Okay, so she finally got the chance to talk to Kirkman after the secret agent guy, the bald-headed guy, I guess he must have gotten her released, which is a good thing because, you know, how else would we have known what her intentions were? So, pretty much, like, she's talking to Kirkman about her suspicions of Peter McLeish and how he's connected to the Capitol bombing, which, personally, after watching how the storyline is playing now, it's safe to say that, yeah, he was low-key. Okay, so then the part that really pissed me off was when Peter had made the press conference, and he's like, oh, he's trying to say he hopes that Kirkman gets well soon and that type of thing, and trying to reassure the country. And I'm just like, no, like, even though it's not like he was, I guess, doing an illegal thing. But honestly, I don't know. It just really pissed me off because Peter, he's fake as hell. I'm sorry. He was definitely fake as hell. Like, why? Like, honestly, like, and it just, I don't know. It just kind of read off to me like he was happy that Kirkman was down so he could pretend to be president for 72 hours. Like, I don't know. I just wasn't feeling it. I was not feeling him at all. So, then it was found out that, Agent Wells, like, pretty much she let it be known that Al-Sakhar was never behind the bombing. And the bombing was, like, pretty much everything was really Peter McLeish. And I guess, the way presidency is set up, like, they have, like, under president, vice president, secretary of state, like, under those three, they have, like, their lineup within the whole house, and the designated survivor will be, like, dead last. So, if anything happens to, like, the whole cabinet, pretty much the designated, well, pretty much that's, like, the whole point of the show. But, like, pretty much the designated survivor will be the new president. So, pretty much, the bombing, Al-Sakhar was just a diversion. And all of a sudden, they're trying to see if Aaron is involved. Personally, I really don't think that he's involved. I really hope that he's not involved. But, I mean, let's see with episode 14 and see what's going on. Because, boy, let me tell you, these two episodes were really, really juicy, honestly. Then, okay, so after they found out that Al-Sakhar was a diversion, Kirkman pretty much realized that he can't trust nobody. He couldn't even trust Aaron. And Aaron is his chief of staff. Pretty much, like, if anybody knows, like, if anybody, like, looks like the actual government, the chief of staff is pretty much the president's right-hand man. Like, if the president needs anything, he or she can count on you. So, the fact that you're behind that is just, it, like, honestly, it's really just a bad look. So, it kind of has everybody looking at Aaron kind of sideways, because it was found out that he had made a call to the Pentagon before before Kirkman had got shot. So it was just kind of, Anyway, so then after that, so Aaron is under investigation. So then after that scene, they brought back Jason. Jason was in solitary confinement this whole entire time, which was actually sad to say, but it kind of gives you a reality of things, because I'm pretty sure there's somebody in the government right now that's in jail being framed for somebody else's crooked, like, it's just a hot mess, really. So pretty much, so Agent Wells, she's trying to find out about the brown-haired lady and that pretty much made Jason take the blame for what's going on. And so pretty much he was like, look, y'all had not found my child yet, I ain't telling y'all shit. That's pretty much what he said, and that was the end of that. So then another scene that pissed me off was when Peter McLeish had visited Kirkman in the hospital. Moving on. Like, honestly. So, after Peter had visited Kirkman in the hospital, he was talking to his wife. And, like, Peter, there was a scene, like, the next scene was Peter's talking to his wife. And pretty much, they were just plotting. Now that Kirkman's down, Peter was the acting president. Okay, so he was talking to his wife and was talking about how Kirkman had asked him to take over his full schedule and doing everything that that Kirkman was supposed to be doing. Peter was supposed to do it. So pretty much he was enjoying himself. The little 72 hours that he got, he was enjoying himself. Okay. So pretty much, like, regardless of that, he was they were still plotting. And I kind of feel like Peter McLeish, he had his own agenda, but then the wife, like, she just kept pushing it, regardless of whatever agenda that Peter had, the wife was just pushing it. Like, she just kept pushing, like, she wanted all the power. But the thing about it is, what people really don't understand is that the president doesn't really have that much power, honestly. Everything, like, and this is, like, not just with the TV show, but this is in real life. The president really don't have that much power, honestly. Like, yes, they do have a lot of power to say yes and no and do certain things, but at the end of the day, Congress has the last say. Honestly, that goes for both the show and real life. So, personally, when you really look at it from, like, a real-world perspective, it's just, like, the hell y'all doing, you know? So, but anyway. So then, like, after that scene, Agent Wells, she went to visit McLeish's military buddy. And that man, boy, he just looked like he was just going through some things. I mean, he looked like he just been through it. So, like, in the for a TV show, that man can act his ass off. Like, like, honestly. Like, he played that character well. Let's just give him for that. So after the follow-up that Agent Wells was doing with the guy, pretty much he, like, there was a call to McLeish saying that, an agent had came by today and he needs to speak with you and da 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 whatever. So, and then I personally think that the Hillary Clinton, even like, I personally think that Hillary Clinton is, like, she's very suspicious of Aaron. And honestly speaking, like, low key, like, I don't blame her, but then again, like, I don't know, like, you really just have to keep watching this episode, because the thing about it is, like, it's like, you kind of have your suspicions yourself already, but then again, it's just like, what if, because, I mean, I don't know, like, you really just have to, like, you really had to have watched that episode, honestly. Then after the talk between Hillary Clinton and Aaron, Peter and his wife, they were talking, and pretty much it was just that, I guess his wife was upset because it's like at the end of the day, technically Peter pretty much had everything in his hands. And so she was just like, yo, you need to understand that, you know, you're not a soldier anymore. They're just civilians and da 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 da. And that's not even the case because, and he's trying to explain, like, okay, that's not even the case because at the end of the day, like, regardless if they're not soldiers anymore, he still had, like, they still have that loyalty to each other. He still has that loyalty towards them. So it's like, at the end of the day, they supposed to have his back, he's supposed to have theirs. Which is pretty much the greatest thing I could actually say about McLeish. And that's probably like the only good thing I could actually say about McLeish, is that that man was loyal to his people, even though they all are a bunch of crooks. So then after that, pretty much, the guy that Agent Wells was working with, he went up to the jail and got to Jason and pretty much was just giving Jason some news that, you know, like he has word out on his son. Like, I guess they must have found his son. But the sad part about that scene was that they found his son dead. So, and honestly speaking, like, I don't know, that part, it really bothered me. Cause I'm just like, damn. Like they could have just left that little boy alone, and they just had to kill him. I really don't know that. That part really bothered me at all. And I don't have no kids, but that part really bothered me, cause I don't know. Then this is the part that had me shook. All right, so pretty much when. Like, back to the scene where, like, McLeish was talking about his loyalty to his, military comrades and everything. So, pretty much, like, when he had got the call talking about, the FBI agent that had met with the guy, he was like, yo, I need to talk to you, da da da. So they had set up a meeting at, Arlington Cemetery. That's when he said, 2100. So, when they had set up the meeting, they just met up in the cemetery. And so the Secret Service, this is the part that really should have been a red flag for McLeish, because when the Secret Service, they had did the I forgot what that thing is called, but the little swiping thing, it's like a body check, like they do it at the airport, and I think hopefully y'all know what I'm talking about. But so pretty much, like, when they had did that, like, that thing, honestly, I'm sorry, but that thing was beeping, because there was a loud beep when that man finished, and I'm just like, that must have been the wire that the FBI had tapped on that man, because I'm just like, how he didn't hear that loud beep, ain't no way. So, then they had, like, their little conversation, and pretty much, like, Peter, he probably thought that he was, like, you know, in the clear to say whatever he needed to say around the guy. But apparently he wasn't, because Agent Wells done ran up on that ass. So, so it was just, like, honestly speaking, like, it was just, like, yo, stop. You're arrested for perjury. I think it was perjury. So, I mean, pretty much, like, that was that. But as soon as she got closer to him, he really didn't plead his case, but, like, he said something, I forgot. But then, the wife was right behind Agent Wells, and so, pretty much, it's like he looked at her, and she shot him, like, dead in the head. And then she turned around, and then she pulled the gun on herself, and that was just the end of that episode. So, because, like, honestly, I'm not even gonna lie. Like, that ending, like, it really pissed me off. I'm just like, ain't no way in hell this episode just ended like that. Ain't no way. So, but here's the thing. But here's the thing. Let's get into episode 13, because this is when the tea starts boiling. All right. So, for the starters of episode 13, what pissed me off was that these people were sleeping in their work clothes. I'm just like, I'm sorry, but that's disgusting. that's really nasty. I mean, okay, you at work all day, you sweating, your booty sweaty, your balls is hot, you in your work clothes. This man was in a full three-piece suit, and he is sprawled out in the bed. No, that's disgusting. And I think he had his shoes on. If I'm not mistaken, he had his shoes on and he was half off the bed. I'm just like, no, ain't no way. So pretty much, that's how the episode literally started off. And then after that, Kirkman, he's back in the White House and everything. And pretty much, that's when he found out about the murder-suicide that had happened at the cemetery. And then, after that, they were just talking. How did that happen? You have Secret Service agents, and the vice president is murdered. His wife killed herself. How y'all let that happen in this right in front of your face? It was just a whole bunch of questions. It actually does say a lot. How y'all let that happen in the Secret Service? The Secret Service was right there. Honestly. But, that was, McLeish's fault, because he has, told him, fall back. I could trust this guy, whatever. So, that was pretty much on account of him. So, what can you do? Then, I finally found out Hillary Clinton's name. I finally called it. Her name is Secretary Hook Stratton. So, yeah, that's my fault. And then, there was one scene where, they had showed Kirkman's wife. She is so damn pretty. Let's just talk about that. She is really damn pretty, okay? I don't know her actual name, outside of the show. But she is really damn pretty, okay? Okay. Then, there was a press conference, and pretty much, Kirkman had let the press know that the vice president is dead. He got murdered, and his wife had turned a gun on herself. And pretty much, they're talking about the answers of why it happened is unknown. It's pretty damn known to me, but you just don't know. That's the only thing. So, I'm pretty sure by the end of the episode, not the end of the episode, but the end of the season, Kirkman's gonna find out everything and anything. Because that's where I personally feel like this season is going, honestly. So, he's gonna find out everything in the end. But it's pretty damn obvious to me, personally. Okay. Then, he also let them know that that McLeish, he had gave the shoot to kill order, which is something that Kirkman would have never done. But I personally see why McLeish did it. But at the same time, I mean, I don't know, I could be wrong, but then again, I kind of do see why he did it. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, him and his wife, they were a bunch of crooks. And they were doing, and honestly speaking, they were doing some illegal stuff. So they wanted to cover up their tracks. I mean, personally speaking, as a viewer, it's kind of, it's low-key obvious, honestly speaking. Okay, then pretty much, they were wondering, the press, they were wondering how the press had found out, because Abe Leonard, he had asked about it, and Kirkman was like, oh my god, that's classified information, how did the press know, da 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 da. So then Aaron had told Hook Stratton, and pretty much she had blabbed to Abe Leonard, because apparently her and Abe Leonard are very close. But regardless if Aaron had told her that, why did she go and blab? That's classified information. I personally felt that should have stayed in the White House. But, I mean, if it stayed in the White House, then they wouldn't have no storyline. See what I'm saying? So, Anyway, so then after that, he told Kirkman himself, and he pretty much got suspended, and Emily became the acting chief of staff until Aaron returned, which I pretty much feel like should have been anyway, because don't nobody got, like, other than, like, his wife and such, don't nobody really have Kirkman like Emily do, honestly speaking. Like, and I really hope y'all noticed it too if y'all watched the show. Okay, so then, like, after that, they have the guy that they had tapped in when McLeish was at the cemetery. They have him in holding, and pretty much Agent Wells, she's investigating him of what had happened in 2005 in Afghanistan and everything like that. And pretty much, like, how should I say this? Pretty much, McLeish was technically a war hero. Like, he's not really a traitor, like how they portrayed him to be, because he saved his comrades' lives. Like, they pretty, like, whatever was going on then, they pretty much, it was like a bloodbath. And it's like they kind of sent them out there to die, literally to die. And there was just, like, their loyalty just, you know, hit from there, because at the end of the day, Peter McLeish saved their ass, really. So, I mean, hey, if you saved my life, of course I'm going to be hella loyal to you. Like, I would not be here if it wasn't for you. So, I mean, but all that extra stuff, I don't think I don't agree with personally. But anyway, so then, from here, it actually started to add up, because McLeish, like, he saved his buddies, and then one of the guys that was trying to kill Kirkman, well, was pretty much the hitman to kill Kirkman, was one of the guys that he had saved. So right about here, it's starting to add up. Like, it's starting to add up, honestly. McLeish was a congressman before all this happened, before the Capitol bombing, everything. McLeish was just a simple congressman. That's for starters. Okay, maybe there was something that was going on within the old White House with the other president and everything, when Kirkman was just a nobody. Right? Okay, Kirkman was literally a nobody. So pretty much now that he's president, and that whole drama when he became president, and people was thinking that he wasn't fit to become president and everything, I guess McLeish probably just thought that man was just a pushover. And, like, you know, pretty much he was just going to get his way one way or another. All right, so the old cabinet is dead. Kirkman has to make his whole new cabinet, whatever. They blindly put, it's not they. Aaron was pretty much, you know, pushing for McLeish to become vice president. That's the key part. He was pushing for McLeish to become vice president. So now with that being said, it's understandable why Hook Stratton is looking at Aaron sideways. See there? So pretty much he was like, all right, you know what? McLeish is vice president now, and that's pretty much it. He's only one step away from becoming president. So all they pretty much had to do was just take out Kirkman, and that's it. It was easy peasy. So with that being said, it makes sense as to why Peter McLeish would ever organize a hit on Kirkman. It makes total sense. Because, like, he wanted the spot. Alright. So, then the next scene after that, there was a scene earlier in the show, and it was when Kirkman and his wife was talking, and they were talking about the kids and how she wanted to go to Camp David because she felt like it was safer there than it was in the White House. Because, so she finally realized, which I personally felt like she should have realized this way before, but anyway, she realized now that since Kirkman is the president, wherever Kirkman goes, he's a target. So there's going to be plenty of people trying to target anywhere Kirkman is. So that means pretty much if her or the kids are around Kirkman, especially if they're in public, they're going to try to go after the kids as well, too. Especially since they got Agent Atwood's, Agent Jason's son, and they killed him and everything. So, I mean, it makes sense as to why she wants to go. So pretty much, and then she was talking about how, he hasn't even been to their school and things like that. So, I'm just like, oh, well, I don't know. It just sounded really sad. It was really sad. But, yeah. So, at this scene now, he pretty much followed the motorcade to the school. And he's seeing how sad his daughter looked and everything. But then, the part that got me was when the however they do the show. Like, when it had focus on the brown-haired lady that was walking in behind his daughter, and he kind of did a double take. I hope y'all know where I'm going with this. Okay, personally, I feel that brown-haired lady is the lady that took, Jason's son. And, that's why I personally feel that it is. But then again, like, later on in the show, like, I guess she was just, you know, nobody, really. But, I don't know. I just kind of felt that's who it is. Because he did a double take. So, and remember this part. They had showed, Kirkman, the camera grabs of when Jason and that lady was meeting, and the hairstyle that the supposed agent was wearing walking behind his daughter was the same hairstyle that the crook was wearing, and it was the same, like, her hair was the same color, her style was the same. So I'm just like, I don't know, it's kind of safe to assume, but then again, it might just be nobody. I don't know. So, then after that, Agent Wells, she goes to visit Jason, and Jason is out the ass depressed. So, and I just feel so bad for him, because it's like, at the end of the day, he feels like he's an embarrassment to his job, because all it took was for somebody to catch his son, and it's like, he just cracked. And then, it's like, he couldn't even save his son. So, it's just like, all those emotions are really just building up. And then, on top of that, like, Agent Wells is on the case. Like, she's on the case now. So, it's just kind of, I don't know, it's like all the emotions are just eating up at him. So, pretty much, like, he just put her out, really. So, like, honestly, like, even though it's just a show, I really feel bad. Like, it just, like, I was just watching, I'm like, damn. Like, that really, I don't know, like, that part really got to me, honestly. So, after that, there's a scene with Hook Stratton and Abe Leonard. Like, I guess they're at the, at a pub or whatever, and restaurant or whatever. And they was just talking, and pretty much, I don't know, Abe Leonard, he kind of puts a bad taste in my mouth. I ain't really feeling Abe Leonard at all. Like, to me, I kind of feel like he's like the Peter McLeish of journalism. Like, I'm really not, like, I don't know how to feel about him. Because, like, at the end of the day, this man, he really just wants a story. And, I mean, like, he's depressed, like, so they all do. But, I mean, I don't really know how to explain Abe Leonard. Like, I think that there's going to be, like, another plot twist in the next episode, especially when it comes to Abe Leonard. Like, there might just be something next episode, because it, like, in the previews, it just looked kind of, like, you gotta watch, you know? Then after that, the kids had left for Camp David, his wife is gone, everybody's gone, and it's just the scene where he's walking through his bedroom, and he's just by himself, and I'm just like, I'm just hoping that Kirkman don't nut up, like, cause he was like how her and the kids are the only things that's really getting him through, and now that they're gone, so this man, I hope he don't nut up on him, cause I really think that, like, Kirkman about to lose his face, like, if anything go down. So, but then again, like, so far, he's really been keeping his composure and things like that. So, I mean, who's to know, you know? Then, after that, there's a scene with Aaron. Like, pretty much the show ends with the scene with Aaron. And I guess he must have been, like, walking into his, I don't know, apartment complex or wherever he was going. And he runs into Langdon. And Langdon is a criminal that they were looking for. He's actually not a criminal. He's, the old cabinet member that they were looking for from the bombing. And pretty much, honestly, it's safe to say that he is a criminal, because I personally think that he might just be connected to Peter McLeish anyway. And I kind of feel like with Peter McLeish, like, he was supposed to be a war hero, and they just painted him as a war criminal. So, but I mean, that man had to do what he had to do to survive. So I'm just like, are they going to say what he is? Or, I mean, I don't know. But yeah, so Aaron, he runs into Langdon, and I guess, the FBI agents must have been in a, what's that thing called? Like a truck, like one of them little spy trucks. And so now they're just, it just ended with Wells and another agent spying on them, and I guess trying to listen in on to what the conversation is between him and Langdon. And that's pretty much it. Like, that's pretty much episodes 12 and 13, honestly speaking. The trailers, next week's episode is gonna be ridiculous. Honestly. It's gonna be really ridiculous. So yeah, that's it. Alright guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And yeah, if you did, give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. And make sure your notifications on so you can keep up with my future updates. Yeah. Bye.